What I'm going to do here is I'm going to introduce you to Power Pivots. Power Pivots are an excellent tool if you have large amounts of data, or you data that's not coming from Excel but from other software, or if you have. Let me show you how to install Power Pivots. Power Pivots is an add-on. Excel 2010. You'll have to download the add-on from the internet. 2013 or 2016, it's an add-on that's built in to Excel itself. It's an add-on that's provided by SQL Server. It's not an add-on as per Excel. So let's go through the steps on how to install it to start with. So we'll go File and Options, and then we will go up to Add-ons, and then what we'll do is we'll go down to the bottom here, and on the add-ins page, we're going to drop down and we're going to select COM add-ins, and we'll select that and we'll go click on go. And then this pop-up appears and you see that I have Microsoft Office Power Pivots for Excel 2013 checked, and you will check this and then you will say okay. When you have this checked on there, you have this Power Pivot tab on your Excel sheet now. So now let's go here. If you go to this and then you go to Manage, it will bring up a new window. And so now it's going to ask you where to get data from. So if we're going to get external data, and now you can get it from databases, SQL Server, from Access, from Analyst Service in Power Pivot, or you can get it from Data Services. You can get other Table Import Wizard. You can get it. There's a whole list, the whole list down. So you can get data from anywhere, basically, to work with Power Pivot. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do it from the Excel sheet that you have. So now I've opened up a new Excel sheet and I have two tables of data on the sheet. I have on sheet one, I have sales for this particular organization. And on sheet two, I have the people, the account numbers and people that are the salespeople for these companies, for this organization. So what I'm going to do, now they are in tables. If they're not in tables, create a table. You need to have them in tables before you can use them in the pivot view. So I have my pivot view table open, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to click add to data model, and the Power view comes up, and there my data has been added to my data model. Okay, and so I have approximately 9,000 records in here, and on my sheet two I have my salespeople and the customer numbers that they deal with. So we're going to click in this. This is a table as well, and we are going to add to data model. And so now you have the second sheet added in. So now we have on our Power Pivot view here, we have the two tables. We have table one, which has 9,064 records, and on the second one with the salespeople and the accounts that they work for, we only have 3,012. Now, advantage to pivot views. If you work in data analysis like I do, 1,400,000 records, which is a limit for Excel, quite often is not enough. In using pivot views, you can have 7 million per records on your data. So you have the ability to analyze far, far more data than you have than just plain Excel itself. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we are going to link these two tables. Originally, when I ran this, I did a index match, and I matched the account numbers to the salespeople. But this is far easier. What we're going to do, we're going to click up here into design, and we are going to create relationships. And so now I have table one, and I want my account number, and I want it linked to my table two is the number. I have salesperson code and I have the number, and I would like to create a relationship between there. So we're happy now, and so now we would like to do a pivot table, both of these tables together. So let's go back to the home tab and let's click on pivot table. And now it is going to put a new workbook in your existing Excel worksheet. So the data is going to be displayed in your Excel book. So you say, okay. Now it looks like the same thing as you have for a normal pivot table. But the difference is you have the tables listed. You have both tables listed and not just the one. And you can check, you can change, select any of the fields from either of the tables. So now let's scroll down and let's click on my other table, and I have the two fields that are available to me in for the other table. So what I'm going to do here is I am going to select from the second table, I'm going to select the salesperson, and I'm going to put it in rows. And the first thing, and the what I would like to do is figure out how much are these salespeople are making. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to total up the amount. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in the total field. And that's as quick and as easy as you can figure out how much, how many sales or how much money these people have sold. So now I have clicked on my pivot table screen that's now added because I have a pivot table on here, and I'd like to create a pivot chart. So I'm going to select this one and I'm going to say okay. And so here you have the data on your pivot table for the sales for these salespeople, and here you have your pivot chart done quickly and easily. So this is an introduction to Power Pivot. I will be making a couple more to additionally to this one as well. Please subscribe.